Now, in this problem, they have given us, in a triangle ABC, if cos A cos B plus sin A sin B sin C equals 1, then prove that the ratio of the sides is 1:1:√2. Is it clear? Now, a very interesting problem. If you find, you will see that sin C is always less than equals to 1. Yes or no? So, we can say that cos A cos B plus sin A sin B sin C is less than equals to cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. Am I correct? So we can say the value of this expression is 1. So this is less than equals to cos A minus B. Hello? Is it clear? Now, cos A minus B, it's an angle. Cos A minus B is an angle. So cos of that cannot exceed 1. Can it exceed 1? No, because cos theta always lies between minus 1 and 1. Therefore, your cos A minus B can take only the value 1. Is it clear? 1 means it's cos 0. So that implies what? A minus B is 0 implies A equals to B. Is it clear? Absolutely. Okay. Now, if I put A equals to B in the given equation, so what we are going to get? Cos square A plus sin square A sin C, that equals to 1. So therefore, cos square C can be written as what? Cos square A can be written as what? If I take cos square A in that side, so we are going to get sin square A sin C is equals to 1 minus cos square A gives you sin square A. Since A cannot be 0, because angle of any triangle cannot be 0, isn't it? So it will not form a triangle otherwise. So in that case, we can cancel from sin square A from both sides. So we are getting sin C equals to 1. Sin C equals to 1 implies C is nothing but pi by 2, that is 90 degree. Is it clear? If C is 90 degree, A plus B plus C is 180 degree. Therefore, A plus B is how much? 90 degrees. Am I correct? Since A equals to B, we have proved A equals to B. So we can write A equals to B equals to pi by 4, that is 45 degrees. Is it clear to all of you? Have you understood how I am getting those angles over here? Okay, now you see, from the sine rule we know that A is to B is to C is nothing but your sine A is to sine B is to sine C. Sine A is how much? A is how much? Pi by 4. So sine A is 1/√2, sine B is 1/√2, and sine C is sine of 90 degrees, 1. So from here we are getting 1:1:√2. Is it clear? Therefore, the sides are in the ratio as 1:1:√2. That's exactly what they have asked us to prove. Is it clear to all of you? Now let us shift for the next problem. Now, in this problem, they have given us, if the sides of a triangle are in AP and if the greatest angle exceeds the least angle by alpha, then show that their sides are in the relation 1 - x:1:1+x, where x is nothing but √1 - cos α / 7 - cos α. Is it clear? Now, first of all, let me just write down what are the given conditions in the problem. First, they have said that the sides of the triangle are in AP. Therefore, we are having 2B is nothing but A plus C. Is it clear? Now, let us assume that A is less than B is less than C. That is, the side C is the greatest side of the triangle. Therefore, we can say angle A is less than angle B is less than angle C. Therefore, the greatest angle of the triangle ABC is the angle C, and the least angle of this triangle is A. And by the given condition, the greatest angle exceeds the least angle by alpha. Is it clear? So these are the two conditions that we are having, that 2B equals to A plus C and angle C minus angle A equals to alpha. Is it clear to all of you? Now, we are having, let me start with the given condition that 2b equals to a plus c, and let me apply the sine rule over here. So we, what we are getting here is, it's 2r sine b equals to 2r sine a plus 2r sine c. Is it clear? According to the sine rule, a by sine a equals to b by sine b equals to c by sine c equals to 2r. Therefore, from that, we are getting this. What is r? R is the circumradius. Now, so let me just cancel 2r from both sides. So we are getting 2 sine b equals to sine a plus sine c, and we are applying the formula sine c plus sine b. So we are getting 2 sine a plus c by 2 cos a minus c by 2. Is it clear to all of you? Now, 2 goes up again. As we all know that a plus b plus c is 180 degrees, so we can write a plus c can be replaced by pi minus b divided by 2, and this is a minus c is nothing but minus alpha, so we can write this thing as minus alpha. Is it clear? Alpha by 2, I'm sorry. Okay, a minus c is minus alpha, so it will be minus alpha by 2. So from here we are getting cos b by 2 into cos alpha by 2. Now, sine b can be written as what? 2 sine b by 2 cos b by 2. Cos b by 2, cos b by 2 goes off. So we are left with what? Sine b by 2 is nothing but half cos alpha by 2. Is it clear to all of you? Now, from here we can say cos square b by 2 is nothing but 1 minus sine square b by 2, which gives you 1 minus 1 by 4 cos square alpha by 2. So what we are getting here, 1 minus 1 by 4, rather I am writing it 1 by 8, so 2 will come here. 2 cos square alpha by 2 is nothing but 1 plus cos alpha. So what we are getting, it's nothing but 7 minus cos alpha by 8. Therefore, cos b by 2 is nothing but 7 minus cos alpha divided by 8. Is it clear to all of you? Till this, it's okay. Now, let me just write what we got here. We got, because I'm going to rub this portion, cos b by 2 is nothing but under root 7 minus cos alpha divided by 8. Is it clear to all of you? Now, let me just rub this portion. Now, let us start with a by c. What is a by c? It is nothing but, from the sine formula again, it's sine a by sine c. Now, applying componendo and dividendo, what we are getting, a plus c by a minus c is nothing but sine a plus sine c divided by sine a minus sine c. Is it clear? Now, sine a plus sine c, actually we got this thing, you know, we have been given 2b equals to a plus c. Na? So from there what we got? We got 2r sine b is nothing but 2r sine a plus 2r, can you remember? 2r sine c. So if 2r goes off, so we are left with 2 sine b is nothing but sine a plus sine c. Can you remember? So sine a plus sine c can be replaced by 2 sine b. Achha, let me just write down this. We are having 2 sine b is equals to sine a plus sine c. So sine a plus sine c, I'm replacing it by 2 sine b. And the denominator I'm expanding, I'm using the formula sine c minus sine b. So we are getting the formula like 2 cos Is this okay with all of you? Sine c minus sine d, what is the formula? Sine c minus sine d is 2 cos c plus d by 2 sine c minus d by 2. Now, 2 goes up again. So we are left with sine b divided by cos a plus c by 2 can be written as cos pi by 2 minus b by 2. And a minus c, if you observe carefully, we are getting a minus c is nothing but minus alpha. So we are having sine of minus alpha by 2. So we are getting what? Sine b over here. Sine b by 2 right here. Minus will come out. And sine alpha by 2. Am I clear? Is till this it's okay to all of you? Okay. Now, we can write, therefore, c plus a by c minus a. I'm taking a minus common just to cancel this minus sign in the right hand side. And sine b I'm expanding as 2 sine b by 2 cos b by 2 divided by, we are having sine b by 2 sine alpha by 2. Okay? Sine b by 2 sine b by 2 goes off. So we are left with c plus a by c minus a is nothing but 2 cos b by 2 by sine alpha by 2. Is it clear? Now, one thing in the submultiple formula, we know that 2 sine square alpha by 2 can be written as what? It is 1 minus cos alpha. Therefore, sine alpha by 2 can be written as what? Under root 1 minus cos alpha by 2. Is it clear to all of you? So let me just replace it over here. Cos b by 2, as we previously got, it is nothing but your under root 7 minus cos alpha divided by 8. Now divided by sine alpha by 2 is replaced by under root 1 minus cos alpha divided by 2. Is it clear? So what we are getting from here? Let me just rub this portion. So what we are getting? We are getting C plus A by C minus A is nothing but, from here we are getting 2 root 2, 2 2 goes off, root 2 goes off, so we are left with under root 7 minus cos alpha divided by 1 minus cos alpha. Is it clear to all of you? Till this it's okay to all of you? Okay. Now, let me just write, because we have been given that x is nothing but under root 1 minus cos alpha by 7 minus cos alpha. So this is nothing but your 1 by x. Right? Now again applying component when dividendo, what we are going to get? Look it carefully. So we are getting what? A by C is nothing but 1 minus x by 1 plus x. Till this it's fine? Absolutely. Now, A by 1 minus x can be written as C by 1 plus x, right? So here we can write equals to A plus C by 2. Yes or no? Can you remember that in class 10 we have done A by B equals to C by D, if it is like this, if the ratio in this way. So you can write this thing as A plus C by B plus D. Yes or no? Okay, so that exactly what I have done. A plus C divided by 1 minus X plus 1 plus X, which gives you 2. Now, A plus C is nothing but, A plus C is nothing but 2B. So this thing is coming to what? B. B means B by 1. So what we are getting? We are getting A by 1 minus X is equals to b by 1 equals to c by 1 plus x. Is it clear? Therefore, we can say that the sides are in the ratio. That the sides are in the ratio. What? Tell me fast. It's 1 minus x is to 1 is to 1 plus x. Have you understood this problem clearly? So, the sides are in the ratio 1 minus x is to 1 is to 1 plus x, where x is nothing but under root 1 minus cos alpha by 7 minus cos alpha. Is this problem clear to you? Have you understood all the problems that I have shown you in the for this property, that is the sine rule property? Absolutely. Now we will go for the second property, which is our cosine rule, right? So in the next lecture, we will do problems on cosine rules.